Hi, my name is Jennifer Hackney Price, and today I'm going to show you how to anesthetize flies and distinguish between the two sexes. So this is something we routinely do in my lab, and I will show you the basics of how that is done. So in my lab, we typically use a CO2 gas in order to knock them out. However, in large teaching labs, you rarely have the setup to use CO2. So instead, we're going to use a chemical called FlyNap that you get for maybe $10 or $11 online. So here's our vial of flies we are going to anesthetize. I put them into a vial without food so that when they do get knocked out, they don't get stuck in the food. Here's the chemical that we're going to use. Again, we are looking at FlyNap. I'm using this in the hood because this is kind of a nasty chemical to inhale. You will get a headache if you start smelling this stuff. So whenever you use it, it's best to use it in the hood. All I'm gonna do for this is dip my little black wand here into this FlyNap. I'm gonna tap my flies down so that they don't escape. And then I'm just gonna insert this wand in between the plug of the vial and the wall of the vial. So our flies are now being dosed, and it usually doesn't take a ton of time for this stuff to kick in. But you wanna just keep an eye out for when they stop moving. As soon as they stop moving, take the wand out, and I'll show you what that looks like. But it is very easy to overdose the flies with this stuff. So you want to keep a close eye on them and seriously just make sure that you get this wand out as soon as they stop moving. The flies have mostly dropped down to the bottom of the vial. There are some stragglers that are still at the top. Sometimes they just get stuck. Even though they're knocked out, they'll still be stuck at the top of the vial. So you can just give them a little tap to knock them down. Give it one last double check to make sure that they're not moving, and then remove the wand. We now have a vial of flies that we are ready to use to look at under the microscope. Okay, so we knocked out our flies, and now we're getting ready to look at them under the microscope. I like to use index cards to put the flies on. It just gives us a nice platform to move the flies around. And bonus, you could label whatever the phenotype is on the index card. So we're gonna dump our anesthetized flies onto the card. And this is where you wanna make sure you have a paintbrush ready to go. We wanna use a paintbrush that has relatively soft bristles so we don't hurt the flies when we start moving them around on the card. So we're going to move these guys onto the platform of the microscope. And what I'm going to do is get a male and female side by side and show what some of those differences are. At this point, I've found a male and a female and just lined them up side by side using the paintbrush so I can start to show you some of the differences between the two. So the first thing that I want to point out is that the females tend to be much larger than the males. Do not use this as your sole identification criteria because there's a bunch of different factors that can influence fly size. But that's a general rule of thumb, is that females tend to be larger than males. The other thing to note is the pigment. The male down here has this nice dark blotch of pigment at the tip of the abdomen, whereas the female has a nice striped pattern extending across the abdomen. The other thing that you can see from here, although it's a little bit harder to see, and let me zoom in a bit, is on the male, you'll see this little black splotch, this little black piece of tissue right on the front legs where you would expect the fly's wrist to be. If you see that little black piece of tissue, you have a male, guaranteed. There are very few mutations that will influence the presence of those what are called sex combs. These are what the male typically uses for copulation. And again, it's not a very variable phenotype. The other characteristics that I was discussing, there's different mutations that could affect the size, the pigment intensity, but the sex combs are relatively unaffected. So if you flip our flies over, you could also examine the external genitalia, which again is going to be one of your more reliable markers. So the male is going to have this external genitalia, whereas the female's not. She's going to have a relatively smooth abdomen all the way down to the tip of the abdomen. So your two most reliable markers when sexing flies are going to be the presence of the sex combs and the appearance of the external genitalia. I encourage you to use multiple characteristics to ensure that you're properly separating males and females. One last thing I'd like to point out is how to spot a virgin female. Now, on my card here, all of my flies are old enough, we don't have any virgins available. But if you look at the abdomen here, you can see that there's no dark splotches anywhere on the abdomen. If this were a virgin female, you would see a nice dark kind of greenish gray splotch right in the center of the abdomen. This indicates that that is a virgin. It is the remnants of the last meal that she had as a larva, and you will only see it on the virgin females, not on any other adult fly. Now you are ready to go and sex your flies and start your experiments.